The real world is much different than you have ever perceived it. There are those who want to take it all away from us, and they want to establish what they call a new world order. A one world totalitarian socialist government wherein each of us will be controlled on a 24-hour day basis and will in fact be chained to a computer in a system of cashless debt which will be more cruel than any prison that has ever been built. You all sit there in your chairs and you watch all of these things being violated. Police breaking down doors without identifying themselves. They rush in, they rip the house apart, they search everything. It's against the Constitution, the basic rights, freedoms guaranteed to us in this country. The reason why you allow it to happen and cheer them on is because they're doing it to minorities, blacks, what some people would call poor white trash, minorities, Haitians, Puerto Ricans, Hispanics. And because you're basically racist at heart, you say, get those suckers, throw them in jail. What you don't understand, though, is when you take away the rights of any single one of us, any one citizen in this entire country, you have taken the rights of all. And by your passive acceptance, after you have been shown what is happening, you establish the law again in the common law that you no longer have those rights. That is a legal fact, ladies and gentlemen. If you do not stand up and claim your rights the moment you see them violated, it can be construed in law that you no longer are entitled to those rights. Wake up. Please wake up.
Cattle, they think we are. How does that make you feel? How does it make you feel? How many of you have a Freemason in your family? 30 on up know exactly what's happening and they're part of it. They'll tell you that they don't. They'll tell you that I'm a liar. Okay? They can't tell you the truth because what? They've taken 30 different oaths that they will never disclose the secrets of the order. Blood oaths on penalty of death. And you say, hey, what about these oaths on penalty of death? All those don't mean nothing. They're just, you know, ceremony. How many of you believe that grown men put on robes and walk around in secret rituals in temples without windows and take blood oaths and don't mean it? How many of you believe that? And if they'll take those oaths and don't mean it, will they mean the one where they have their hand on the Bible? Of course not. They're lying to you. They are liars. Chronic liars. Ceremonies and oaths give them permission to lie if it protects the secrets of the order and tells them it's okay. Now, how clear does it have to be before somebody wakes up? How many days do we have left? See, I told you yesterday, I'm not nice to people anymore. There's no time to be nice. No time to stroke you and make you feel good. I got to wake you up quick, and I got to get you ready to fight for your freedom, or you're going to make me a slave because you won't fight with me, or you'll make me dead because I'm the only one fighting. I don't like those odds, but whether you're with me or not, I'm going to fight. They're talking to us clearly. We don't hear what they're saying because we don't understand the language.
But he left one final warning.
1984 is, I believe, a quite terrifying masterpiece. So terrifying, in fact, I don't think I should like to read another like it.
I am not absolutely dissatisfied with it. I think it is a good idea, but the execution would have been better if I had not been under the influence of TB when I wrote it.
You once claimed that you have an ability to face unpleasant facts. Is that what you demonstrated in 1984 by drawing an accurate portrait of the future?
I think that allowing for the book being, after all, a parody, something like 1984 could actually happen. This is the direction the world is going in at the present time. In our world, there will be no emotions except fear, rage, triumph, and self-abasement. The sex instinct will be eradicated. We shall abolish the orgasm. There will be no loyalty except loyalty to the party. But always, there will be the intoxication of power. Always, at every moment, there will be the thrill of victory, the sensation of trampling on an enemy who is helpless. If you want a picture of the future, imagine a boot stamping on a human face forever. The moral to be drawn from this dangerous nightmare situation is a simple one. Don't let it happen. It depends on you.
Triggered.
Same documents that I saw, and he tried to warn the world just like I'm trying to warn the world, but he wasn't willing to take the risk that I'm willing to take, so he wrote it in a book called 1984 and spelled out exactly what's coming as a warning to the people of the world, as a work of fiction. But you notice that that work of fiction really stirred people up, because they knew that it wasn't fiction. In their heart of hearts, everyone who's read that book knows that it's coming.
It's a possibility.
Most people won't recognize it overtly or publicly, because then, if they recognize it, they have to be responsible to do something about it. And that's what every one of you have been resisting all your life, is being responsible to do something about it, to get involved. That's why you'll walk away from a girl being raped on the street by a gang of thugs, rather than go and try to help her. And I'm not talking to all of you. I know there's some of you out there just like me, but most of you are just exactly what I've just described. Most people are no better than animals who do not have intelligence, because they don't use their intelligence. And to these men who control things behind the scenes, you are stakes on the table by choice and consent, and will always be ruled and manipulated and enslaved by people who do use their brains.
Sex, 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 crime, crime.
The world we are preparing, Winston, is a constant victory, constant triumph. Beginning to accept it, you'll soon welcome it, and finally become part of it.
Hey,
can I take this content with your eyes only? In this place, stranger home, I know there's always somebody is crying.
In 1949, George Orwell had a vision of the future. Today, that vision is still a best-selling novel, and his prophecy remains as terrifying as ever.
If you want a vision of the future, Winston, imagine a boot stamping on a human face forever.
A future where freedom becomes slavery, where privacy is forbidden, the past forgotten, and where living people simply vanish. Yet one man and one woman dare to love.
Can you get Sunday afternoon off?
Yes.
Take this.
Everyone knows. The thing that is in room 101 is the worst thing in the world.
They can't get inside you. They can't get to your heart.
John Hurt, Susanna Hamilton, Cyril Cusack, and Richard Burton in the crowning role of his career.
What are your true feelings towards Big Brother?
I hate him.
You must love him. It's not enough to obey him. You must love him.
The film of the book of the year. George Orwell's 1984.